Hello, and welcome to my new show, Cooking in Pajamas, where we are going to discover what happens when we take a plane and we cut it into three-dimensional objects. All right, so our first object that we're going to start with is a sphere-like object. It's not a perfect sphere. This is a clementine. So what we're going to look at today is if we take a 3D object and we basically slice it. So we take this knife, this is our plane, and we're just going to slice this piece of fruit. What 2D shape do we imagine that slice is going to create? So when we open this up, what shape is going to be on that inside edge? That's our cross section. It's what happens when we take this plane and we cut this down the middle, what 2D shape does that create inside? So let's explore. We have our sphere. We're taking our plane. We're going to cut it down straight down the middle. Let's hope this doesn't get juices everywhere. So now we have our plane that's slicing our fruit, making a cross section of this sphere. If we open this up now, on the inside, we've created two circle-like cross sections. It's not perfect, again, because this isn't a perfect sphere, but it's about the size of a circle. If we were to take our cutie and slice it the other direction. So now instead of slicing vertically down the cutie, we're going to slice horizontally and hope that Miss House doesn't cut off her fingers. And when we do that, what shape do you expect this cross section to make? It's the same, it's a circle. And this is because no matter how we cut a sphere, it's always going to create a cross section of a circle. Now hold on one second, I'm gonna grab another cutie so we can cut it even more. All right, so now we're gonna take this cutie and we're actually gonna cut it diagonally. So I'm gonna start at this top edge or top corner up here and cut diagonally through that. As you can imagine, both sides of our 3D shape now have a cross section of a circle in the middle. All right, we're gonna move on to new shapes now. So we're going to take a cylinder-like object. This is not a perfect cylinder, it's a banana. So what we're going to do is we're going to take our plane and we're going to see what shape, what 2D shape do we create when we cut down the middle of this banana. On the inside, we've created a circle. I could also cut this horizontally. I could cut it this way, horizontally through the banana, and we'd have a different shape. This is not going to be a circle. If I take this and horizontally cut through this banana, now all of a sudden, I've created a different shape for my cross section. All right. Next on the chopping block, is our cube-like shape. Again, not a perfect cube, it is a roll. So what shape are we going to create if we cut this shape? Let's cut it horizontally. So we're gonna cut through here. What 2D shape do we create in this cross section when we cut that plane? This plane is creating a slice in the shape of that slice is a square. the shape of both sides will always be the same. So a square. If I were to cut this vertically, again, if I slice this, the shape that is created by this cross section is a square. Same on this side. It's a square. And our last donut shape, this is a bagel. If I were to cut this horizontally through here, it's kind of already sliced. Let's not chop our fingers off. That doesn't make for good television. Okay. Knife safety. Okay. So we cut that horizontally through there. This is our slice for our bagel. Then the shape that it creates is the same shape that was at the top of our 3D image. We're just cutting into it. It still looks like that donut-shaped figure. All right, so what you can do with this, if you want to explore this some more, and you don't want to cut up all of your fruits that you have in your kitchen, I posted the link for, let's see where to go, for this website where you can take, it's a simulation. So you can take a 3D image, you can take a plane, that was our knife, and cut through an image. So we're gonna start with sections of rectangular prisms. So what you can do with this simulation to explore what kind of shape that you're going to get for that cross section when you cut through a 3D shape. So this height button right here, this is going to raise your plane. It's kind of like my knife cutting through here. You can change whether you're cutting horizontally or vertically. Notice how that orange shape right there, that orange shape is what is that cross section. That's the shape we're looking for, that rectangle right there. So you can change horizontal to vertical, maybe. You can also rotate it around so it's still parallel to the bottom. You can move your plane around, and you can change how thick, how opaque you want your plane to be. So you can really see that when this cuts through, that orange shape that's left, that's our cross section. If we take a rectangular prism and we slice a plane through it, no matter how we do it, it's still going to be a rectangle. So you can explore over here on the left side. If I took a cylinder, so this is kind of like our banana, when we slice through our banana, we got that circle shape. No matter where you're slicing it, you're going to get that circle shape. But if I cut it the other direction, all of a sudden, I'm not getting a circle anymore. Just like when you saw that when we sliced the banana this direction, it's not a circle anymore. If I slice that cylinder vertically, all of a sudden, I'm getting a rectangle. So this is a good site to just go through and explore. You're going to have a Khan Academy assignment to do. And this is a great way to like check your work, to work through it before you answer. There's everything on here. So you've got triangular prisms. You can go through cutting horizontally. It's a triangle, but if I cut vertically, it's a rectangle. You can do a cube. You've got lots of options, cones, pyramids. So the link is on Google Classroom for this. You can explore through that. Email me if you have any questions, and thank you for joining me for cooking in your pajamas. Bye, guys.